I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey whippersnappers, this is Brian at A Boomer Reacts. This is a channel where a boomer, me, reacts to rap and hip hop, a genre that I know very little about. If you saw my video about Juicy by the Notorious B.I.G., not only did you find out that I didn't know the Notorious B.I.G. and Biggie Smalls are the same person, but I had no idea what this East Coast, West Coast rivalry was, and why Notorious B.I.G. got killed, why Tupac got killed. And I did a little research, and you know what's funny is a lot of the stuff that ignited this rivalry was music, was songs. It's the 80s, okay, the late 80s, and that was my decade. I was 24 when it started and 34 when it ended. But I was really in a new wave. I really wasn't into rap and hip hop. In fact, there wasn't a whole lot of that. Radio wasn't really playing it. MTV wasn't really playing it. In fact, MTV really didn't start playing black music until Michael Jackson. So you would hardly catch any rap or hip hop. LL Cool J was around. Salt and Pepper was around. Ice-T was around. But you know, I didn't follow that genre. Blondie, Debbie Harry, which was a new wave band. She did a song called Rapture that had rap in it, and you know, I don't like to include that as a rap song. You know, I'm torn about that song. On the one hand, you could say that she culturally appropriated rap, you know, for her song, which became a big hit, or if she recognized rap in its early stages as something that people should pay more attention to, and she brought it to the forefront by doing it in a song, then that's cool. I just don't, you know, I'm not in her mind, so I don't know which one took precedent for her. I would like to think that she brought it to the forefront because people weren't paying attention to black people doing it. So here a white woman had to do it, so it became popular and then it was more acceptable, which is shitty, but you know, that's the reality of, you know, black life in America. It's shitty. So it's the 80s. Those groups that I mentioned are, you know, like starting to chart. And there's people on the East Coast, people on the West Coast. And then in 1988, N.W.A. came out with their Straight Outta Compton album. And Straight Outta Compton, the song, and also Fuck the Police was a track off that. And I haven't heard any of it. I haven't seen the movie Straight Outta Compton, so I don't know anything about this song. But the reason I'm putting it as part one of this rivalry series, not because it had anything to do with the rivalry per se, it's just for context, because the rivalry starts next episode, but you need to know about Straight Outta Compton to be able to understand what's coming in episode two. Okay, so let's get to Straight Outta Compton. 1988 it came out. And made quite the sensation.
You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Motherfucker named Ice Cube from the gang called Niggas with Attitudes. When I'm
Okay, so this was the song and album that kind of propelled rap and hip hop in the 80s towards, you know, more hardcore gangster rap. You know, I can't relate to this song at all because this is not my experience. And it's got a good beat and I'd like to bop my head to it, but he's talking about some really distasteful stuff. So let me know in the comments how you guys feel about this, because this came out way before you were born. Is this something that appeals to you? Or has it softened since then? Because this just seems like very aggressive. Like, you know, this would not put me in a good mood. This would make me want to go out and, you know, hurt somebody. Which, you know, music is an expression of your emotions. And that's cool. Totally fine with that. But if the emotion you put down on vinyl is motivating people to go out and, you know, shoot up people and cause violence, I'm torn. But, you know, I'm an old white guy, so what do I know? Let me know what you guys feel about this, looking back, you know, way before you were born.
What's up?
Tell them where you're from.
Straight out of Compton. Another crazy ass nigga. More punks I smoke, yo, my rep gets bigger. I'm a bad motherfucker and you know this. But the pussy ass niggas won't show this. But I don't give a fuck, I'ma make my snaps. If not from the records, from jacking a crap. Just like burglary, the definition is jacking. But when illegally armed, it's gone packing. Shoot a motherfucker in a minute. I find a good piece of pussy and go up in it. So if you had a show in the front row, I'ma call you a bitch or a dirty ass hoe. You probably get mad like a bitch is supposed to. But that shows me slut talking post to a crazy motherfucker from the street. Attitude legit, cause I'm tearing up shit. MC Ren controls are automatic. For any dumb motherfucker, it starts static. Not a right hand, cause I'm the hand itself. Every time I pull an AK off the shelf.
So now here comes the misogyny. Ladies, how do you feel about this? If I was you, I'd be like, fuck you, dude. But, you know, I'm not you. And I can't tell if this is all for show. I'm sure life experience has been put into these lyrics, but I don't know how exaggerated the aggression is, because this is Ice Cube in 1988. And how much longer after this was he, you know, starring in comedies, you know, like Barbershop and stuff. So, who is he? Is he the mean, aggressive guy with an AK-47? Or is this all for show? And what he really is, you know, like an actor and wants to, you know, be more mainstream. I don't know.
Security is maximum, and that's a law. R-E-N spells red, but I'm wrong. See, because I'm the motherfucking villain. The definition is clear, you're the witness of a killing that's taking place without a clue. And once you're on the scope, your ass is through. Look, you might take it as a trip, but a nigga like Ren is on the gangster tip. Straight out of Compton. 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 Compton.
Is his name and the boy's coming.
Straight out of Compton is a brother that'll smother your mother and make your sister think I love her. Dangerous motherfucker raising hell. And if I ever get caught, I make bail. See, I don't give a fuck. That's the problem. I see a motherfucking cop, I don't dodge him. But I'm smart, lay low, free for a while. And when I see the punk pass, I smile. To me, it's kind of funny. The attitude show a nigga driving, but don't know where the fuck he going, just rolling. Looking for the one they call easy. But here's a flash. Never seen like a shadow in the dark. It's like when I unload, you see a spark and jump over a hesitation. And hear the scream of the one who caught the lead penetration. Feel a little
I don't get it. You know, it is so far removed from my universe. So it's hard for me to comment. If I was a woman, I wouldn't like these lyrics. If I was a young guy out on the streets, wondering, you know, who's been listening to this music. God, I sound like those, people that say violence is caused by music and video games. Sorry, I don't mean to sound like that. You know, I like how the music sounds. It's just like, you know, the lyrics are so hard. And I don't know if, you know, they're genuine. I'm sure, you know, Ice Cube has some frustrations about living on the streets and the cops. But he's venting his frustration. But me personally, I don't know if, like, this is the best way to do it. But like I said, that's just coming from, you know, an old guy. So this came out 1988, so let's say 1990, and you guys are probably, you know, late teens, early 20s. So yeah, this is like ancient history for you. And gangster rap's not a thing now, right? I mean, sure, there's songs that express anger, but are there songs right now that say, you know, get out your AK-47 and if you shoot a bitch, you don't care? And it doesn't seem like that would fly right now. Anyway, so the guys that are in the group, I wrote them down, Dr. Dre, Eazy-E, Ice Cube, Arabian Prince, and I know there's one more, MC Ren. So, oh, and I'm sure there's one more. Sorry. I forget who you are. I wrote it down, but I didn't keep it with me. Anyway, so to set the scene, so that's N.W.A. doing Straight Outta Compton, and it's a big smash, L.A.-based, of course, Compton, and it kind of changes the trajectory of rap and becomes very popular. And some New York artists have something to say about it. And that's going to be in the next episode. So stay tuned. Episode 2 will be focusing on a song that was considered to be like one of the best diss songs. And it's, you know, in answer to the West Coast's newfound popularity. So hopefully you'll tune in for that. If you like this kind of content, please subscribe and like this video. And forgot to tell you, I was born 3 miles away from Compton, just like in a neighboring city. So I'm straight out of Compton, approximately. So hope to see you next time. It'll be episode 2, The Diss. Bye.